You can't afford to be without your vehicle. Bobby and his team of professionals at A1 Quick Oil will get you back on the road fast and with the job done right. All technicians are 100% certified. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars. We fix them.
Well, even over the holidays and right after the holidays, the parish council work continued with Chairman Brigette Hyde. And good news, the biggest road overlay project we've ever authorized, and that's only the start of it. Other road projects, too, being done with federal and state funds, including some big ones in your district.
Right, Ken. With the extra sales tax money that we've had coming in over the last few years, we were able to add to our overlay. We approved our overlay project for 2022, so hopefully at the beginning of next year, people will start seeing work take place in their area again. That will be all throughout the parish. We also have a couple of big projects, like you said, in my area, at the four-way where Hoover and Airport meet Sisters Road. There'll be a roundabout going in there. We're also widening the road. It'll go to 200 feet past the rec park entrance, so hopefully that'll help alleviate some of the traffic issues that we have there. We're also doing the bridge on Sisters Road between the four-way and Dunson. That area of the road will be straightened, and we'll put a wide bridge in, so I'm excited about that because it's a very, very dangerous spot. So those projects hopefully will get started pretty soon.
Well, the federal and state money may dry up eventually, but it looks like the sales tax increase is here to stay.
I believe that. I know I heard a lot of people talking about how they were shopping at home for Christmas. I did as much of my shopping as I could in Tangipahoa Parish. There were just maybe one or two things I couldn't find that I had ordered, but I think that we have new shops. We have better opportunities for people to go out and find gifts. I know in Ponchatoula we have some really neat little shops where people can find unique items. So I'm excited that people are trying to shop more local, and that puts money back into our local economy.
And it also does not look as though the growth is going to abate any.
No, we've got our census numbers back, and our parish has grown, but it's not been significant, Ken. If you look at the way the numbers are, people from the north have moved down, to the south end of the parish. So it's more of a redistribution than really, a huge growth that you would think.
So when you look at economic development, new businesses coming in, the growth in the housing industry, and then of course sales tax receipts, retail, you just can't find a fly in this ointment, can you?
No, it looks like 2022 is going to be a good year for us, Ken. People that are trying to sell their homes, they put them on the market, and within days they have, four, five, six, I've even heard as much as 10 offers, full price offers. Some people are even offering more than they're asking. So the housing market looks like it's going to continue to boom. Our sales tax, like we talked about previous, have been up and stayed up. We attributed that to COVID at first because people weren't getting out. They were staying close to home and shopping, but we're just continuing to see that trend follow. COVID is hopefully starting to wane, and we don't see the people getting sick like we did, even with this new variant. I haven't heard of anyone that has it that's gotten severely ill, so hopefully 2022 is going to be a lot better than the last 2 years that we've been through.
You look around the state, and we had lockdowns for a very brief period. We had restrictions. But compared to New Orleans, we're way ahead, and our businesses are way ahead.
Right.
And then Louisiana, compared to some of these other states, is mind-boggling how great we have had it here.
Right. You're right, Ken. There was a time that you couldn't go out to eat. The movie theaters were closed. But we really did, I feel like, get back on track quick, and we were able to get our businesses back open. A lot of our business owners got creative and did outside dining, or some of them put in food trucks to be able to continue with their business. So I don't really know of anybody, even in the restaurant business, that was significantly impacted.
Well, now, of course, we have the labor shortage, but that'll eventually straighten out. And you just have to believe it's a reason for optimism going forward, because our hospitality industry emerged intact after this pandemic. A lot of places can't say that.
Right. I think one thing that hurt our local food industry as far as employment is with the university closed, that's where most of these the kids that work in these restaurants, they're students who come from out of town and live here, and when they weren't here going to school, we didn't have that labor force here.
The end is near. The final days are here at A.M.H. City Furniture. After 17 years, we're closing forever in a matter of days. So we invite you to negotiate your best deal now. If you're reasonable, it's yours. And with so much inventory still on hand and just days to liquidate it all, we can be very reasonable. Negotiate on living room. Negotiate on dining room. Negotiate on bedroom. Negotiate on anything in the store. If you're reasonable, it's yours. And everything is in stock and ready to go. You can take it home today. After 17 years, the final days are here for A.M.H. City Furniture. This is a safe store. Shop with confidence.